Hey everybody, it is Dak here from the Ed Boys, and welcome to our Runescape 2007 1-99 Fishing Guide. Fishing is a very simple skill to level up, but at its fastest, it's still pretty time-consuming to get 99. There are a few ways to make some profit with fishing too, and we will talk about those at the end, but keep in mind, there are a lot of methods out there, and these are just the ones that I prefer to use. Before we jump right into the leveling guide, let's talk about some helpful items that you can use while you're fishing. First of all, the Dragon Harpoon is an equipable harpoon that requires 61 fishing and 60 attack. You only need 61 fishing to use it, but if you want to equip the harpoon, you do need 60 attack. While fishing on harpoon spots, the Dragon Harpoon is 20% faster than a regular one, and if you do have the 60 attack to equip it, it has a special attack which temporarily raises your fishing level by 3, which isn't a huge boost, especially with it being still a little bit pricey, but it is going to continue to drop in price. Eventually, maybe it is in your price range, and you can always sell it back when you're done. And in the long run, it could help you speed-wise, so it's up to you if you want to spend the money on it. You can also get the Angler's Outfit to help train fishing. Each piece of the Angler's Outfit gives a little bit of bonus XP, plus an extra bonus for the full set for up to 2.5% extra XP. You can get the Angler's Outfit from the Fishing Trawler minigame. The bonus really isn't huge for the time needed to gain the outfit, but in the long run, if you get it early on, you can save a few hours when getting to 99 fishing, so it is kind of up to you. It's not huge, it really, it's just okay. We can go ahead and jump into the leveling guide. At level 1, you can only catch shrimp with a small net. There are a few quests you can do for your first levels, but it really is easy just to sit down and start catching some shrimp. I suggest catching these things all the way to level 20 at the Draenor village, right by the bank. You really don't have to bank the fish though. If you're ever far away from a bank and you're fishing, you can usually just drop them, that's better for XP. Of course, if you're fishing something expensive, you probably want to bank them. It depends whether or not you're looking for XP or money or a combo of both. If you are unaware, you can currently set an option in your settings to just hold down shift and click an item to drop it, making it super fast to drop a whole inventory of something like fish, for instance. And at level 15, while you are catching shrimp, you're going to start catching anchovies automatically, which is kind of nice because it's a little bit more XP. From levels 20 to 48, you should start fly fishing. You can fly fish by the Barbarian Village. Since it isn't by a bank, you're going to want to drop your fish, but it's very easy to get there. You can do this in the Shiloh Village too if you've done the Shiloh Village quest. If you want to bank your fish, that's a pretty good way because it's pretty close to a bank. But really, these fish are pretty cheap. It's not that big of a deal. You will need a fly fishing rod and some feathers for bait. At level 20, you can only catch trout, but once you hit level 30, you're going to catch some salmon for a nice XP boost. If you enjoy this method, this is one of the faster fishing methods in the game, so you could potentially take it all the way to 99. At level 48, you can begin to Barbarian Fish, which does take Barbarian Training, but Barbarian Training is very quick. Just south of the Barbarian Fishing spot, you can talk to Otto to get done with that. But once you can do Barbarian Fishing right at 48, you're still going to get lower XP rates, but once you're in the 70 to 80 fishing range, you're going to start to get 50k plus an hour without much effort, which is pretty good for fishing, and it's very AFK. You could potentially bank at the Barbarian Outpost just north, but it's really going to slow your XP down, so it is recommended to just drop the fish. Especially with that shift drop, it really makes it easy. You can also 3-tick fish here for up to twice the XP, but I'm not very good at 3-tick fishing, or ticking anything for that matter. If you've ever seen my DK's trips, pretty ugly. If you're interested in learning exactly how to 3-tick fish, this isn't necessarily the guide for you, but I'm just throwing that out there as it is an option and a pretty popular option. If you're not that big on the click intensive part of it and you're looking for the AFK still, just stick with some regular Barbarian fishing all the way to 99. Since all you do with fishing is really just collect raw food, and food will always be needed in RuneScape, really any fishing method is going to make you some profit as long as you're banking the fish, but let's talk about a few better ones. The simplest fishing moneymaker has to be monkfish. It only requires 62 fishing and a small fishing net, but you also have to do the Swan Song quest. Monkfish make a decent profit for how AFK it is. Even right at 62, you don't catch them unbearably slow. The XP year isn't that bad for the profits, so it is a viable fishing method to take all the way to 99 if you're looking for a good mix of both. Sharks are like a step up from monkfish. They require 76 fishing, and I would say the best place to catch them is definitely the fishing guild. Don't forget that you can use a dragon harpoon to speed up these catches, which is pretty big for sharks. This still isn't huge profit. There is really no fishing method that makes like ridiculous profit, but it is more GP per XP than monkfish. So if you want to take this all the way to 99, you can. It's going to be pretty slow, but it's one of the best ways for making as much money as you can from 99 fishing. With 82 fishing, you can catch angler fish, but you also need 100% favor in the Piscorilius house on Zaya to catch these bad boys. They require a normal fishing rod and some sandworms as bait. I'm assuming if you've gotten 100% house favor, then you're aware of how to get sandworms, but if you're not, those little buckets of grubs that you turned in for house favor, if you just click on those, you get some sandworms out of them, if I'm not mistaken. But you can also purchase them from the general store, which is the same person that you gave the buckets of sand to. He sells some of them, so it's very simple to get bait. As with other moneymakers, angler fish, they're very AFK, and the profit doesn't really compare to something like Blast Furnace, but it's not bad for GP per XP, so if you're looking for a lot of money by the time you get your cape, angler fish can do the job. If you're into a little bit of higher risk fishing, you can catch some dark crabs in the wilderness resource area. They require 85 fishing, a lobster pot, and dark fishing bait to catch. Of course, being in the wilderness means that you could lose some fish out here, but it's very AFK, and the XP really isn't that bad to take you to 99. You can also use your fish on, his name is Piles, standing around in the resource area. He'll charge you 5 coins per fish, but he'll note your fish for you so you don't have to bank as much. I still don't have 1,000 noted dark crabs on you. If you get PK'd out there, you're just going to lose all your dark crabs. But if you have like 2k total world, or you're just paying a lot of attention, probably not going to get PK'd much. With 87 fishing, you can catch sacred eels. With 72 cooking, you can then dissect these eels for a couple of Zulra scales. The XP here is really not great, and the money here is not as good as dark crabs either, but it is very low risk, very AFK, because you really never have to bank. And if I'm not mistaken, this is like the only way to get Zulra scales without actually killing the snake or buying them from the GE, or just another player in general. There's a brand new fishing moneymaker that just came out with the Inferno, released on June 1st. With 80 fishing, you can catch infernal eels. If you're wearing ice gloves when you catch the eel, they'll harden up and then you can use a hammer on them for a reward. Usually it's Tokel, but sometimes you get lava scale shards or an onyx bolt tip. The XP is supposed to max out at 35k per hour, so that's at 99, so you probably aren't going to get 35k per hour while you're trying to get your cape. And I have estimated the profit never really gets above 150k an hour. You're probably looking more like 125 for the majority of your fishing. So it's not amazing, but it is a brand new moneymaker, so I thought it was worth mentioning. One minor detail I forgot to bring up about sharks was that they can also be tick manipulated, I believe would be the category you put them under. You can actually two-tick sharks. It takes a different area than the fishing guild. I don't know much about it, so I will, again, not try to teach you about it, because you don't want to learn from me. You won't know how to do it. This is how it is. But if you want to look up on how to two-tick sharks, it's not the best XP in the game, but it turns out to be the best way to get the pet in the game. So check that out if you're interested. But that is going to wrap up the guide, everybody. I do hope you enjoyed or got some useful information. I used to put annotations in the guide to help update it after it came out, just in case I missed anything or I misspelled anything. Any edits that I needed to do. We don't really have that option anymore because annotations don't exist. So go ahead and check the description if you need. The top of the description will be any edits in the video. And comment any questions or just comments about the video that you have so we can add stuff to that list if necessary. Thank you very much again for watching. Hope you got some good information and best of luck with your fishing.